Because there has been so much interest in the RC2014 Z80 computers and accessories, I've decided to take a look back at the build of the RC2014 Mini computer. This is a system that you need to assemble yourself and comes as a bare circuit board and all the components you need to create a working Z80 computer. If you haven't used a soldering iron before, you should get some practice before you start on this project. The assembly isn't difficult, you just need to take your time. Plan out what you need to do and the order it needs to be done. The instructions are well laid out and there is even a video to show you the best order to solder in the components, to which I'll put a link in the description below. Set aside 1 to 2 hours to complete the assembly. Here we see the RC2014 Mini fully assembled. The edge connector at the top is only needed if you are planning to add extra modules like graphics cards, storage, etc. You can leave that off until you decide what you want to do later. The computer can either be powered by a lead to the barrel jack or by an FTDI cable. As you'll need the FTDI cable to communicate with the board anyway, I set the 5V FTDI jumper on the board. Here we see the board fully assembled and with the FTDI cable plugged in and supplying power. The power LED is quite bright and you can't miss the fact that the board is powered up. At this point you need to set up your communications application, for which I chose Teveterm. Links in the description below. When you plug the FTDI to USB cable in, then your computer should identify this as being on a COM port, likely to be COM3. Click the new connection and select this port. I'm making the font setting bigger to make it easier to read the text in this video, but you can choose whatever suits your setup. Now that's set up, click the reset button on the board. Initially, I've set the jumper links on the board to boot up straight into BASIC. Click C for cold start and just hit enter when the memory top prompt appears. Now we are in the BASIC programming language, which is a traditional line number BASIC. This allows us to create and run BASIC applications. The RC2014 at this point in time has no storage facility. We'll add that in the next video, so you won't be able to save your applications on the RC2014 at the moment. But there is nothing to stop you exploring what this retro BASIC language can do. Once you have typed in your code, just type run and then the enter button to run your application. Next, we are going to power down the board and move the jumpers to let us boot up into the small computer monitor to allow us to view and amend memory locations directly and enter the world of Z80 assembly and machine code. The memory map of the RC2014 Mini gives you free memory starting at 8000 hex, so we're first going to set some memory locations using the fill command to 0. Just to prove this worked, we will use the memory display command to bring up their values, which appear as all 0. We are now going to amend some memory locations directly to enter some machine code in hex. You really can't get closer to the metal than this. This little routine I'm entering will copy data from 8000 hex to 8050 hex for 20 bytes. You can of course use the A command to enter this in assembler, but I'm using the edit memory to show the disassemble command later. Having entered all the code, we can display it in assembler format. A Z80 system is 8-bit, but its registers can be used in pairs to give the effect of a 16-bit register to allow it to address memory locations. Here we are loading the HL register pair with 8000 hex, which is where we want to start. The DE register pair holds the location we wish to copy to, and the BC register pair the number of bytes we wish to copy. The LDIR command runs a loop to copy one byte at a time from the source to the destination until it has copied the number of bytes requested. The C9 or return command signifies the end of the routine, returning control to whatever called this piece of code. Now if we have a quick look at the 8050 hex location to prove it has no data in it yet, we can see all the values are zero. And we can then run our code by using the G command. Now we can have a look at the destination 850 hex to see if our code has been copied successfully to the new location, which it has indeed. So we can see that we now have a fully functional Z80 computer, able to run both basic and assembler routines. In the next video, we will upgrade this to add storage to the system. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.